Yes, we are absolutely delighted to be announcing that we are launching Coffee Break Books. We have been working on this for a long time and we are very excited to be sharing these with you. I've got them here. Here they are. These are called 50 Coffee Breaks and it is a brand new series which will help you learn your language, at the moment in French, German, Spanish and Italian, on your coffee break. And it's a different way of learning on your coffee break. Still the same coffee break learning, of course, but it's, let's say, just a different style of learning, something that you can get you away from your phone, away from your computer, and take it with you, take your learning wherever you go. So I'm sure you've got lots of questions, and of course we'll be answering these questions as time goes on. But to tell you a little more about this, I would like to welcome my colleague Eva, who has been our series editor for this this whole project, and Eva's going to tell you a little more about our 50 Coffee Breaks books. So here is Eva.
We're really excited to be taking this first step into the world of books and to be introducing a new way to help you practice your language skills on your coffee break. As language learners ourselves, we feel that it's really important to have a whole variety of resources that you can use during different moments during your day or your week to fill in those little gaps of time with just a little bit of language learning. And that's why we feel that having a coffee break book of language activities will hopefully be a really useful resource that will help you do just this. We love the idea of having a physical book of activities that you can open up and you can write inside. You can write down the answers to your activities. You can circle things and highlight things. You can write down the new words and phrases you're learning to help you remember them. And you can flick back through the book and have a look at everything you've learned over the past while. The books have been designed in a way to help make it easy for you to fill in whatever time you have with a short activity. They're divided into three sections according to roughly how long it'll take to complete each of the activities. So 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or 15 minutes. So if you just have 5 minutes in one day, you can turn to the first section of the book and choose an activity from there. Or if you have a little longer, you can turn to the 10-minute section or the 15-minute section and complete an activity from there. Another really important aspect of the books is the idea of variety. And when we were choosing the types of activities that we wanted to include in the books, we felt that it was really important to include different sorts of activities to help you practice different skills. So one day you might choose to do a reading text exercise to help you practice your reading comprehension, but the next day you could do more of a grammar-focused activity. There are also exercises to help you practice your translation skills, your writing skills, and your vocabulary building as well. We've really enjoyed putting these books together as a team, and we really hope that you enjoy using them and that you'll enjoy learning from the same teachers with whom you're familiar from other coffee break lessons who have all been involved in writing the books. In this way, you can benefit from the same coffee break learning, but just in a new format. I'll hand you back to Mark now to tell you a little bit more about the 50 Coffee Break series.
Thank you, Eva. And the is exactly what Eva said there. We've got books we've got activities that will cover your 5 minute coffee breaks, your 10 minute coffee breaks and your 15 minute coffee breaks. So just whatever you have time for in the course of a day, you'll be able to, I'm looking at it here, it's great. You'll be able to work through it. And of course you can write in them, you can take notes, you can do all of the things that you would do with a normal book. I'm seeing somebody saying everything that's old is new again. And that's exactly how we feel as well. It's great to have the digital resources, but having a physical resource, I think, is something that is really exciting and really useful to be able to take it with you wherever you go. So we are going to be looking a little more in detail at the kind of activities that are included in the book. And for that, I'd like to introduce Maurizio, who is another member of the team and has been working very closely on these books. So over to you, Maurizio.
The 50 Coffee Break series is designed for higher beginners and intermediate learners of French, Spanish, German, and Italian, for now at least. These are hands-on books that will help you practice your language in several different areas. Each one of these 50 activities have been designed by native speakers who really enjoyed creating material to help you boost your language skills on your coffee break. With this book, we aim to help you achieve your language goals day by day, or as we'd like to say, cup by cup. The language you'll be able to practice with these books is authentic language, language that is used by native speakers on a daily basis, language that will come in handy in your next conversation in French, German, Italian, or Spanish, or on your next trip abroad. Now, I'd like to tell you something more about the activities you can find in these books. Whichever skill you want to practice, we have you covered. If you want to review some grammar points, we have a 5-minute long mini grammar challenges that can help you look at, for example, irregular verbs or prepositions. And if you have some extra time, you can get into a more in-depth grammar consolidation activity to review maybe the future tense or past tenses. To help you improve your reading skills and expand your vocabulary, we have prepared some recipe activities or profiles of famous speakers in each one of these languages. You can learn how to make a focaccia or linzertorte or pulpo alla gallega while learning some new important words. Speaking of expanding your vocabulary, what about a 5-minute word builder on describing people or maybe traveling or going out for food? If you have more time, you can challenge yourself with an anagram or a vocabulary consolidation activity to delve into specific parts of vocabulary. These are only some examples of the activities you will find in the 50 Coffee Breaks books, but you will also find many more activities that will help you boost your reading comprehension, writing skills, and translation abilities. As we always say at Coffee Break Languages, there's always a cultural thread that goes through everything we learn. So all of these activities will help you build cultural awareness of the countries in which these languages are spoken. You will learn about some idioms, some famous quotes, typical dishes, and well-known speakers of these languages. As one of the people involved in this project, I can't wait to hold the books in my hands, and I really hope that you enjoy your coffee break, or should I say, your 50 coffee breaks.
Grazie mille, Maurizio. So as Maurizio said, there's a whole range of different types of activity in the book, and you're going to be practicing different skills as you go through the book, which is something really important. Language learning is about acquiring skills in many areas. Thank you to all of you for the questions that are coming in, and we're going to have a Q&A session at the end of this broadcast. So do keep the questions coming if you've got particular questions about the books. Now, we have been working with these books with a very well-known partner in the field of language learning, and that is the team over at Teach Yourself at John Murray Learning. So many of you will be familiar with the Teach Yourself books and the other book series that Teach Yourself publish. Well, we are delighted to be working with Teach Yourself to be able to bring these books not just to Amazon and online places, but to bookshops all over the world. And we're really excited to be doing that. I am very pleased to be able to welcome two of our colleagues from Teach Yourself, Sarah and Chloe. So let's have a chat with them now. So it is my great pleasure to welcome Sarah and Chloe from Teach Yourself. Good afternoon to you both.
Good afternoon, hi. Mark.
Would you like to introduce yourselves for our audience, please?
Sure. My name is Sarah Cole, and I am Publishing Director for John Murray Learning. And at John Murray Learning, we publish Teach Yourself, Chambers, Michelle Thomas, and some academic series such as Language Acts and World Making.
Fantastic. And Chloe?
Hi, I'm Chloe West. I'm the Project Editor for Languages at John Murray Learning and Teach Yourself. I help out Sarah quite a lot.
And we've been working with both of you and indeed more members of the team over the course of the past few months as we've put together these books. And we're really delighted to be able to work with you on this. Sarah, can I ask you to begin with, why did Teach Yourself want to work with Coffee Break on these books?
First and foremost, Coffee Break is a brand that I very much personally admire. I think it has a really strong personality, I think it's grounded in good pedagogy. There's clearly expertise in everything you do. And what's interesting is I think you were very digitally innovative while everybody else was kind of still trying to figure out what that actually meant. So, you know, I've kind of been following what you do for a long time. And what's interesting is that over the years, through our own research, we've found that more and more people want bite-sized learning. They want shorter pieces of learning. And it's not exactly what we've done. And I think coffee break, that concept, you just really got that early on. And it comes down to like what makes a successful learner. And I think it is about finding routines, sticking to it, making a habit of it. And that's what keeps you motivated. And I think you just got that. So, you know, we really wanted to work on this series because obviously it's the first time you're going from the digital space into the print space. It's what we're experts in. And I still believe that there's a benefit to writing things down when you're learning to assist in your memory. And I think there's also a benefit of disconnecting from phones. So there's just a synergy there that felt really obvious to me. So I'm glad that I was able to convince you to do it with us.
Fantastic. I think that's exactly right. It's this idea of getting away from your phone, using your phone at the right time, but then getting away from that and having a different learning experience. And for us, the most important thing has been that it's still this coffee break experience. In addition to these coffee break books, obviously Teach Yourself has got a huge range of different books available. Chloe, can you tell us a little more about the range of books that you have to offer?
Yeah, sure. So at Teach Yourself, we have kind of the core series, which are our Get Started, Completes and Enjoy. So these aim to take learners from beginner level to intermediate. And we publish these in over 70 different languages. And then alongside that, we also have books that kind of focus on the grammar and vocabulary specifically. So these are our tutors series. And then we also have our standalone series. So these are kind of outside our core list. These are our like language hacking series, our foreign graded reader series and script hacking. So these might focus on particular skills such as learning a language through reading or speaking. So yeah, we've got a huge range of different language books and we're excited to have Coffee Break join us.
Yeah. And we're delighted to join that family. Sorry, Sarah, carry on.
No, I was just going to say what's important to me as a publisher is that we're always trying to fill gaps. We never want that overlap of offering the same thing and confusing the customer. And I think that's another reason like we wanted to work with you is that we have nothing like this to offer our learners at the moment. And now we do.
Fantastic. I mean, from our point of view, obviously, every single element of learning, every opportunity that a learner gets to use their language and to practice their language in different ways is important. So we always recommend, of course, that it's not just Coffee Break that you use. You use the Coffee Break in connection with a whole range of different resources. And we know that many of our learners do exactly that. Sarah, it's been a few years that we've known each other. We've been talking for a long time.
Yes, we have. And I remember the first meeting that we had at our offices back on Euston Road in London. And it was my predecessor who set it up. And I think we both sat down together and kind of wondered, why are we actually talking to each other? Aren't we competitors? Why are we giving away our secrets? Obviously, she saw something really exciting in what you were doing. But from that point, I think, you know, we stayed in touch. We've helped each other out in different circumstances and have seen each other at conferences. You've attended some of our events, which has been wonderful. We've even met recently in Boston when you were at a podcast conference,
right,
I think.
Yeah.
So we've always found these touch points. And I think it was like 4 or 5 years ago, you came to visit me to start talking about potentially working on a print product together. So I think that sort of planted the seed, but then it took actually 5 more years for that to come to fruition until we found, you know, the right way to collaborate. I think we, you know, for me, I always wanted to, and this just felt like the right moment.
And we are delighted that the rest of our team have been able to be involved in this whole process, and our regular meetings with the other team members have been really, really good fun. I don't know about you, but I'm really excited to be bringing these books to many bookshops around the world.
Yes. And again, I think that's where there's a lot of synergy between what we can do together, because obviously we have the distribution and the relationships. And I think bookshops still matter for brands. And obviously you have a huge following and great fans for your brand, but this will bring hopefully more recognition and get more people excited about language learning and about making it fun and, you know, making it more of something, how do you say, turn your downtime into due time.
Absolutely.
And I know, Chloe, we've been talking about just generally, like internally, how we're all so excited about it as well.
Yeah, we're excited to see kind of the books, like the physical copies of the books, especially because Coffee Break is sort of so outstanding in the audio and digital side. We're excited to kind of bring your work into print form and bring it to more readers and a wider audience. Yeah.
Thank you both very much indeed for being part of today's event. We're delighted to continue this relationship and looking forward to when the books actually arrive in the bookshops and so on, and indeed to take the next steps in this 50 Coffee Breaks process with you. Thank you. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mark. Thank you.
So thank you both to Sarah and to Chloe. We are very excited about this, as you can tell. We've got lots and lots of questions, and perhaps one of the key questions that many of you are asking is, how do you get the books and when are they available? Well, the books are they're available for pre-order today. And because these are physical books, they're print books, and we want to launch the books on the same date around the world, or the same time around the world, these books are going to be available from early June. So you can pre-order today and you'll be able to get your hands on them in June. Now, there are many questions coming in, and to help me answer these questions, I am going to bring Ava back on. So Ava, I think if I press this button, you hopefully will be back. Yes, there you are. Hi, how are you, Ava?
I'm very well, thanks. How are you doing?
Very well. I'm very excited to be launching these books. Thank you for joining us today. Yeah. And indeed for all the work that you've done on the books. We've got lots of questions. Yeah. And I'm going to scroll back through just to see if we can get them. I think one of the key questions that many people are asking is, basically, if I put this one on the screen, I think we've got John's question here. So will you continue to produce your podcasts? Absolutely. The podcasts, the online courses, the video content, that's not going anywhere. But what we wanted to do with the books is add something else, bring a new audience to the Coffee Break content, and to bring new content to those of you who enjoy learning with Coffee Break. So the podcasts aren't going anywhere. Let's see. I'll scroll back and look at some of these questions. So Patrick's asking a question about level. What level is it aimed at? Excuse me, I'm going to have to mute my microphone. Eva, do you want to take this?
Yeah, I'll answer this while you cough away. So the level of these, it's a kind of high beginner to lower intermediate level, roughly A2 to B1, according to the Common European Framework of Reference for Languages. But within the books, there's quite a range of level within the different activities. Some might be more a chance for you to review things that you're quite familiar with already at that level, and other things might challenge you a little bit more. So there's a little bit of range within that.
I think that also is going to depend as well on the amount of time you have available. Again, everything's organised in the 5 minute, 10 minute, 15 minute section. So perhaps something that is a more challenging activity may take you that little bit longer as well. So depending on the level, you'll be able to do a different type of activity. Someone else is asking, let's see, I saw a question. Here we are. Yeah, Judith is asking, that's just disappeared. Sorry, but Judith, let me see if I can find it. Sorry about this. Judith is asking, will there be intermediate or advanced books at a later date? Ava, what's the answer to that one?
Well, in terms of intermediate, this should cover an intermediate level, you know, and as Mark said, you can kind of, some activities might take you a little bit longer, a little bit shorter, depending on your level. And if you're more kind of intermediate, higher intermediate level, then I'm sure there'll still be something for you in them. In terms of an advanced level, this is the start of a book's process, and I guess we'll see where we go with it.
Absolutely. Nadezhda is asking, will there be an e-book version of this course, Eva?
Yeah, there will be. We'll have a print version and also an e-book version available. Obviously, it's a different experience using an e-book, and a big part of this project and the books is going to be the idea that you can write in the books and you can write your answers within the books, which obviously you won't be able to do with an ebook. So they're laid out slightly differently. They don't have all the lines for you to write on. But I think to get the most out of the ebook version, we'd recommend using, your own notebook or a piece of paper along with it, so you can still have the experience of writing down as you go. But just, in a different way.
Yeah, and that whole idea of writing, as we've said many times, writing things down helps the memory process. It helps you consolidate the language by physically writing it. So we would certainly recommend maybe taking your ebook alongside a notebook or something. Or indeed, I like Jeff's comment here, if you can leave the book pristine if you're so inclined. You don't like to write in your books. That's absolutely fine too. There's no necessity to write in the books at all. So we've got some questions about how can you order from different places. So Pravesh is asking how you can order in India. Jacqueline is asking about where can you order the books in France. And Edward's asking about buying them in the UK. So by the time it comes to June, these books will be in all good bookshops. For example, in the UK, they'll be in Foyles, they'll be in Waterstones, and all the bookshops that you would imagine. They will also be available, of course, to order online. And the main place to go to find out all the information you need about the books is coffeebreaklanguages.com/books. And there are links to the worldwide Amazon links for purchasing the books, also to Waterstones in the UK, and to Book Depository, which is a distributor, a worldwide distributor. And the Book Depository can send books anywhere in the world. So again, these will be released in June, but you can certainly pre-order from today, and we will be actually running a few little prize giveaways and things like that with the pre-orders. But you can stay in touch with us to find out more about that. Indeed, on that page there is actually a place that you can send us your email address, and we'll keep you posted as to all the pre-order giveaways and all the information around the books as we're getting closer to launch date. Let me just take that out the road. So Sarah is asking a critical question. Can I enjoy Coffee Break Languages if I don't drink coffee? Absolutely. Yeah, that's not a problem. Coffee is not a prerequisite of learning a language with us. So yes, absolutely. Richard is asking an interesting question. Do you want to take that one, Eva?
Yeah, this is a great question. So yeah, with how connected the content in the books is to the podcasts and the online courses. The 50 Coffee Breaks books, they aren't an accompaniment to any specific courses we already have. They're a separate thing. They're just like an extra practice of what you might be learning in one of our courses or in the podcasts or elsewhere, wherever you're learning your language. But they're just providing extra practice. They're also... they're non-linear. You're not going to kind of learn alongside in the way you would with a course as you go through it. It's just you can turn to something in particular that you think looks interesting that day and have a little bit of extra practice. So they're a self-contained book.
They are indeed. And I don't know whether you'll be able to see this, but there is... can I show this? Will this work on the camera? I don't know. You can see there's a checklist. So Eva mentioned the checklist earlier, and there's a checklist that you can tick off each of the activities that you've done so that you can see which ones you've still to do. And obviously, of course, all the answers are provided in the book too to help you work through what you've learned. But it's very much not a linear process, as you said. It's something that we can you can work through just whenever it suits you and pick an activity to challenge you over the course of the day. Some lovely comments. C of E is saying, love this. I'll be using these on road trips and camping trips. Fantastic. Megan saying, love the idea of being away from my phone and computer to learn. We've answered that question, and we've talked about advanced learners. Karen's saying, I love this way to take a coffee break. Reading is an amazing way to improve your language learning. We definitely totally agree there with you, Karen. Jay's saying, the books are so attractive. Thank you. We're very pleased with the way they look too. Maria is asking, we've kind of covered this question in a sense already. Will they be supported by online resources? Ava, do you want to take that?
Yeah, so yeah, as we've said, they're not directly related to the online resources, but there is some extra support there available with the books if you need it. For example, we've included a sort of index at the back where a lot of the language points that come up throughout the activities are all listed there. And so if you need a little bit of extra revision to go over a certain language point again, then you can turn to this index at the back and you'll see which of our coffee break lessons includes a more detailed explanation of that language point. So yeah, you can go online and you can have a look for those lessons and you can review whatever language point you need to there.
Excellent. Okay. I'm just going through some of our further questions that have come in just making sure that we're not missing any. So Sheila is asking, where in the existing coffee break journey can you start using the book after Italian season one, for example? That is a very good question. Ava, I think you're best placed to answer that if you're okay to go with that one.
Yeah, I think, as we said, it's sort of upper beginner to lower intermediate level. By the end of season one, I'm sure you'll be able to get lots out of the book. There'll probably be some quite challenging things in there and things you can work towards. But yeah, there's a lot of help within the book in a lot of the reading text, for example. You've got vocabulary lists that list the main piece of vocabulary in a text. And of course, you can always turn to the index at the back as well, as we said, and look for extra help on the language points. But yeah, about lower intermediate and higher beginner level, we're saying.
Great, thank you. So many questions. I'm not sure that we're going to get through them all. We do have to finish at a certain time. Let me just jump over here. There's a couple of quick questions. So Rosa is asking, how many activities in total? Is it 50? It is indeed 50. And that's the idea of the title. There are indeed 50 coffee breaks within the course of the book. Dottie's asking, how many pages to the book? Ava, is it 260 or thereabouts?
272.
Thank you.
There you go.
Natasha's saying, don't forget independent bookshops. Absolutely, we would definitely not forget independent bookshops. These books will be available for any bookshop to bring in and sell. So the independent bookshops will definitely be featuring the books. Barbara's got a great suggestion. When repeating a section, you can write in different colour inks and then you can actually see your progression. So you're doing the same activity over again, but doing things in different colours. Fantastic. Gina is asking, sorry, I'm getting hoarse today. So looking forward to getting my hands on the Italian one. Is there an Irish language one? At the moment, we have got the books in French, German, Spanish and Italian, but the plan is to bring in more languages in the future. We're not quite sure of the order of those further languages, but we're looking forward to working alongside the Teach Yourself team on identifying the next batches of languages and hopefully at some point in the future, even bringing in a new batch of 50 coffee breaks for the existing languages. So all that to come in the future. Trying to make sure we've not missed any important questions. Someone here, IJ Sunsum, has just ordered from your favourite bookstore right now. That's fantastic. Thank you for doing that. So if you're joining us later than we originally started this, we are announcing the publication of four books These are the 50 Coffee Breaks series, and we've got them here. So 50 French Coffee Breaks, 50 Italian Coffee Breaks, 50 Spanish Coffee Breaks, and 50 German Coffee Breaks. And this is the perfect way to take your coffee break learning further than through podcasts and online courses and through our social content. So I hope that you find this exciting and useful. I think we are almost there. We've got quite a number of questions about other things today. We're not really able to go into all of these. Lynn's saying, just trying to order on Amazon just now, but it's unusually busy right now. It must be all the Coffee Break fans. Well, fingers crossed. That would be great. A very, very good question. Michael is asking, are the activities in the French version the same as in the other versions? Eva?
No, they are. They're the same types of activities. We've included the same kind of style of activity, but they're very different across the languages. Obviously, the different languages might have different language points that are particularly tricky for learners at this level. So we've kept it separate for each of the languages. So if you're learning more than one language, then you're not going to get bored by doing the same activities in two different books, for example.
There you have it. So it's very much, we wanted to make sure that the books also reflected the different cultures appropriately. So where something might be perfectly sensible to do in Spanish, it might not work so well in French. So we've tried to keep that in mind as well as we've been developing the books. Lots of you saying pre-ordering right now. Thank you very much indeed. We're delighted to see that. To pre-order, if you go to this website, coffeebreaklanguages.com/books, then the pre-order links are on there. You just need to scroll down to find the books and you'll be able to pre-order on there. Okay, just a couple of other questions here. John's saying, just looked at the website, didn't see where to buy the books. So just halfway down the page, scroll down the page, you'll see all the book links there to buy the books. And of course, if you search for Coffee Break Languages on Amazon, for example, or Waterstones or wherever you get your books, you should be able to find them. One final message here, and that is from the Teach Yourself Languages Open Road team. Hello to Mark and the Coffee Break team. Hello, everyone. We've so enjoyed working on these books with you and are excited to bring out your first print products. Well, we're delighted to be bringing these out with you. So thank you for all the work that you've done along with us to help us bring this to fruition. Eva, thank you very much for today. Thank you also, of course, for all the work that you've done on the books. To find out more about the books, as I said, go to coffeebreaklanguages.com/books. And we're going to finish off just by playing our video one more time to raise the excitement levels a little bit more. Thank you so much, as ever. It's been a great event with so many of you watching live. And of course, if you're watching in the future, then we hope that you have enjoyed this too. Thank you. And as ever, happy coffee breaking.